Same question. Black liquid actually has magnetic properties. We're gonna be doing some experiments with this ferrofluid today. They look insane.
Also, join my notification squad by clicking the bell right here because I'll be liking and replying to a bunch of early comments every week and I'd love to chat with you.
Let's get on with the video. Let's go. We're gonna start off with something simple today. I bought this ferrofluid kit online. It's got a little bit of ferrofluid. Comes with these two little magnets. Ooh, it looks like a little slug. Whoa! Guys, it's like turned into like a little porcupine. We let go. Whoa, it just slides back down. This is crazy. All right, let's have a look at what happens when we add an extra magnet to the mix. So I'm gonna show you guys what happens with a regular magnet. Nope.
Nothing.
Okay, so obviously these magnets are a lot stronger. Let's see if these two kind of... Oh yeah, not as strong. At least I can pull them apart.
Whoa.
So they... Oh no. This again.
Oh, can you guys see that? How cool does that look? Does that look like a jellyfish?
Change the distance with the two magnets and they'll just kind of float from side to side. Whoa. That was just a little warm up. I have a whole bottle of ferrofluid here and a bunch of magnets. Stuff is actually pretty dangerous. If you guys are gonna play with this, make sure you get adult supervision. Let's go. Oop, I'm a bit scared. I don't know what's gonna happen. That looks disgusting. Let's just pop it on the side of the glass and see what happens. Can you see that? Whoa! I feel like I grew a little monster.
You can get like a mini one.
That's crazy. Can we get an even minier one from the mini one? Whoa. Magnets cause the ferrofluid to spike when you put it on the side of the bowl. But when I go to the bottom of the bowl with the magnets, it looks like it's not strong enough to cause it to spike. As you can see, I only got like a few little spikes and they're kind of big. I want to create a giant spike on the bottom of the bowl. So how am I going to do that? Whoa! Check out this magnet. They're huge. These are extremely strong. So if you do plan on playing with these, make sure you get parental supervision. I actually almost like squashed my fingers just then because the edge of this table is actually metal. And even when I get to about here, I can feel the magnetic pull towards the table. I'm kind of afraid of it. As you can see, this magnet is so strong. I'm literally just attracting the ferrofluid, but I'm not gonna get too close because I'm afraid once I do, I'm not gonna be able to withstand the magnetic force. So what I'm gonna do is tape this under the table so at least we have a barrier between the ferrofluid and the magnet. I am so nervous right now. I don't know if this is gonna work, but if I can get your help, I think it will. So if you guys can go find the like button and click it, I'm gonna give you guys 3 seconds to do it. Ready guys? 3, 2, 1. Have you done it? Also, don't forget to click the bell to turn on notifications. With your help, this is gonna work. Ready? Whoa! Oh my gosh! They look like little armies of like spikes. I'm gonna move it closer. Oh my god, they're getting tiny! So the reason why this happens is that there are tiny little magnetic particles inside the fluid. And these spikes actually form along the magnetic lines, which causes them to form in this particular pattern. Magnet, catch my ferrofluid! Whoa! That's crazy! What's happening? You know what, guys? I think we're gonna need some more. Awesome, here we go. It seems to be just getting fatter. I was hoping it was gonna like grow in height. We're gonna see what they feel like. Let's see if it's gonna stab me. I hope not.
Whoa,
they're just soft.
They're like being attracted to my finger. What is that? Look, they're like hugging my fingertip. I feel like I could just disappear into the spikes. Whoa.
This looks crazy. So after I disturb them, they pretty much form again pretty quickly. So they're not fazed by me because there's this magnetic resistance from the metal underneath. When I'm pushing into the middle, it feels like something's like repelling me back. Like it doesn't feel like liquid, it feels like slime. Doesn't smell good, guys. So if you guys can't find Ferrofluid, you can actually DIY it yourself. Print a toner, vegetable oil, and we're gonna mix this together and see if it works. Ready, guys? I feel like this DIY is a fail. I'm just gonna give this a thumbs down. Look, the spoon is stuck. So I heard Ferrofluid goes pretty crazy when you put it on random objects. The first one is this screw. So I've got this pipette and I'm gonna take a little bit of Ferrofluid.
Whoa, oh my gosh. Can you see that, guys? It's traveling down the spiral. You know what it looks like? It looks like a cake emoji. I love how it's just like standing up on its own and it's not tipping or anything like that. And it's just slowly traveling down the spiral.
Whoa! Okay, maybe it went a bit too fast.
Oh my gosh, guys, it's collecting on the bottom in another little like circle thing. Let's see what happens when I put more. Whoa!
Next up, egg holder. Found this pretty weird spiral egg holder. I'm really curious as what it would do. Let's have a look. Oh, what? Okay, it looks like it's not gonna stand up properly. It's just the best we're gonna do today. I call it the leaning tower of egg. All right, let's start at the top. Whoa, that is cool. I love it how it just kind of doesn't drip or anything. Like it feels like it's defying gravity. Whoa, it's like guaranteed gonna land on the metal. They're growing on this side. What if I, oh. That got a bit messy.
Bad idea.
And now it's time for this random thing. I'm hoping it's gonna look pretty. It just goes straight through.
Okay, well, I know this is not in the middle. Let's move it a bit. Whoa. Whoa, what just happened?
This is kind of a letdown. I was expecting a little bit more from this. And finally, we have this lock. Don't ask me why, I was having trouble finding metal things. I'm scared I'm not gonna be able to pull this off the magnet.
Ooh.
It didn't break,
right?
Okay, we're good. Ah! Yay!
That looks crazy. Whoa, look how small these spikes are.
Are they sliding down?
Can you see those ones getting bigger and they're just dropping? Oh, they just want to like go to the edge. They don't want to hang in the middle. Can you see that? It's like literally going up.
It feels like there's only like one path for the fluid to go and that's all they'll do. Even if I try and like put the fluid elsewhere, they're like, nope, we want to go there. That's where we'll go.
Now let's see what's gonna happen when we drop a rare earth magnet directly into the ferrofluid.
So I'm gonna get a pool of ferrofluid onto this plate.
Ooh, that kind of looks really satisfying. All right, got the magnet here and I'm just gonna drop it straight onto it.
Whoa, it's got a life of its own. That's crazy. It's getting bigger. It feels like there's absolutely no friction between the magnet and the plate. Oh my God, look how quickly it's going. That's crazy. Does that look like a flower yet? Now I'm gonna try and pick it up. Come on, little one. Whoa. I can't pick it up. What is it doing? I literally just can't pick this up. It feels like a little like squishy Orbeez ball. We should play like a who can pick up a ferrofluid magnet challenge, because you're gonna be here like 10 hours later and you're still gonna be doing the same thing. Let me try and squeeze it. I got it. I hope you guys found this video interesting. Let me know what you guys thought down below. It was pretty crazy. This is the first time I've played with ferrofluid and it was so intriguing. And a huge shout out to my notification squad member of the week and Wengie corner of the week. If you guys want to get a shout out in the next video, don't forget to check the subscription box to find out how to enter. And also don't forget to follow me on social media for behind the scenes and to see what I get up to during the week. And until next week, I'm gonna miss you guys so much. So I'll see you guys then. Bye guys.